What's up, guys? The May Patreon rewards are now available. Cyclonic Rift, Jace the Mind Sculptor, and Avacyn, Angel of Hope are all available through the end of the month. If you'd like to support our channel and pick up these sweet proxies, you can do so at patreon.com/itresolves or by clicking the link in the description below. What is up, guys? Welcome to part two with Izzet Aggro. This is a deck that I kind of found online, not one that we've seen a ton of in the best of one ladder, at least in my experience. And I kind of altered the list a little bit because it felt a little bad, if I'm honest. If you want to check out the full list, it is down below, but you can also check out part one of this video. We kind of give a more in-depth reason as to why we have all of the cards in here. I don't love this hand. It's a bit we've got Lava Coil, but it's a bit non-interesting. Now, it does have the three of the four lands to get to Crackling Drake. I'm going to try it. We'll see. If you didn't check out part one, though, we actually had very, very good luck. We had a great time playing, and I don't know. I'm kind of excited about this list. I feel like it's got a lot of the things that it needs in best of one to do very, very well. It looks like we're potentially against... What? I was thinking Azorius. Clearly that is incorrect. I mean, Azorius control specifically. Maybe that is still happening. This is a weird one. So it looks like we are mill? Thassa's Oracle. Okay. We'll wait. That's interesting. Probably just gonna Lava Coil that next turn. One top, two bottom. Yep. Let's radical idea here. Interesting. Not sure about this. We'll play that. We'll play this. Just to get that out of there. Folio of Fancies, huh? Interesting card. Do not see this in the best of one ladder, at least in my experience. I think this is the first time. What in the world? Okay, I'm in. This is a cool deck, whatever it is, I'm in. We're gonna opt here. Just boosting up our Crackling Drake for next turn is the idea here. Do we want shock? Probably not, right? No. Yeah, that's fine, they can have it. I don't care. Yes, that's fine. Decline. There you go. We're about to draw a card. This is unfortunately very, very good against us. I mean, we gotta do what our deck is meant to do. Wow. Okay. I just don't get what they're doing here exactly. Okay. Very, very intrigued by this deck. Resolve, decline. Okay. Let's just shock here. I don't really know what they're up to. This is such a weird deck to me. No idea. We could have actually dealt one more, but that's okay. We'll throw this out. We'll throw Augur of Bolas out. Sure. So get a butt ton of mana. Whatever this is, I'm into it. It's pretty cool. I mean, they've got a million. They've got 15 mana specifically. They keep saying good game too. It's a bit annoying. Okay. They get to do it again. Yep. I'm letting him do it because this is interesting to watch, just for the record. This is really cool. Like, I guess they just win with Thassa's Oracle? No, because this just shuffles back into our deck. Never seen that before. Resolve all. I don't know, this is cool. I like it. Right on schedule. Don't worry, I got this. Okay. Well, everybody draws 17. This is so silly. Yeah, I mean, I'm not doing anything. I'm just auto passing. Sure. This is just fun to watch. This is so cool. I'm not doing anything. I don't know. This is awesome. I'm in. I feel like this is like either you really, really win or you really don't win, but this is cool. I like it. I'm so glad we're up against this deck right now. 100% we're probably going to lose. Like, there's no way we don't. They've got another one of these, so they can draw our entire deck. But I think we both lose, if I'm not mistaken, because they just end it in a draw. I'm letting them do it. Fight me. This is cool. This is really cool. Sure. Okay. They left four cards in the hand here. Did they mean to do that? Or in the deck, excuse me. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, so they win. That's fine. This is super cool. This is such a silly deck. I'm in. Nice. Well done. That was really cool. We lose. That's fine. That was amazing. I've seen like silly combos like that before with those cards, in fact, but I've never seen them work that well. So well done, opponent. That was just fun. That was a cool start. We lost. I don't really care. All right, let's jump into game two. I'm excited, guys. Hopefully we have a little bit more of an exciting match on our end. But we'll see. Yeah, we'll keep this. Keep. I'm actually just going to let this come into play tapped. We'll pass on the opt for now just because we'll want to get the counter on it. It looks like a Garuda deck, huh? Yep. These Garuda decks are really, really cool and really, really mean. But we'll see if we can beat them. This is definitely a deck to beat. When it comes to best of one laddering, probably best of three as well. I just never really play best of three. Sure. Yeah. You got it. All right. Let's do this. Oh yeah, we can't technically do that, can we? Let's opt here first, then. Don't actually want that. Alright, well, we got it anyway. Let's just go ahead and shock here. And we'll attack. Technically didn't need to shock ourselves, but that's fine. Alright. See what they do. They need one more land, it looks like. They can attack in with this if they wanted, but I guess they probably don't want to leave the option open to shock it. Alright. Not an amazing draw, if I'm honest. Huh. What do we want to do? Kind of think we just Chemister's Insight here. Next turn, we're going to have one heck of a time. That's for sure. Thassa's annoying. Yeah. What did they hit? Is that a... They really didn't hit much, did they? Paradise Druid. Or Sprite Dragon. Not the worst thing in the world, if I'm honest. Let's do this. Can we... What's our count right now? So if we do that... Then we do this. Beacon Bolt coming in clutch. We'll swing in. I'm sure they've got, you know, something in hand, so that's not a huge worry. Though, if they had, they probably would have played it from the hand, I guess, the first time. We'll see. Yep. They can just continuously kind of tap this down, though, too. Which, they're leaving up more than enough mana to do so, so that's no big deal. Alright, let's throw this out there. I mean, it's Crackling Drake. You're gonna tap this. That's fine. This just gives us a separate way to win. Kind of questioning whether we just leave up Unsummon. I'm going to do that. I don't know if that's 100% correct, but that's what I'm going to do. The only reason I'm doing that, if they like Garuda, for instance, and they miss, we'll just Unsummon their Garuda. I think that makes the most sense. Or if they, like, steal one of our things, we Unsummon it. It goes back to our hand. I mean, I think that's the best option. Thank goodness for Beacon Bolt. Holy crap. I mean, we are still dealing a lot of damage in the air, don't get me wrong. But, like, that definitely would have been a problem. Okay. So, these are instant. Let's just go ahead and attack. They're going to tap one thing down. Can they tap two? One, two, three? Yeah, they can, can't they? Yeah. All right, well, let's just do this then. Yes. So, let's just shock here. Would love to get another Crackling Drake on the field, but I don't think we'll be able to. Oh, well, we just win. They should have also... Could they not have? They could have. I think they just missed it there. That was kind of a mistake, I think, because they had 4 mana up. They could have tapped down the Crackling Drake. Sorry for the frame rates, guys. All right, well, we got one. Let's try and do our game 3 here. Let's see if we can win it. I'm loving this deck. I'm really, really loving this deck. It just feels good. Like, it just has a lot of good value stuff in it. And I think it's tooled fairly well for the best of one stuff. This is great. I'm definitely going to be leaning on the mountain. That way we can shock something that comes down if we'd like. Especially against a creature deck. Hi. How are you? Maybe, actually, let's just play Tiffany. Or Temp. Let's play Tiffany. Let's play Temple. Sorry for the frame rates, guys. Hate that. I really hate the frame rate thing. It's really annoying. Okay. This is an interesting one. We'll play you out, and we'll play you out. God, get rid of that. And let's attack. Glad this wall doesn't have reach. That's annoying if it did. That would be annoying if it did. We can also just unsummon this if we would like. Yep. 100% gonna shock that. Nope. Let's go ahead and draw a card here too. I think that's the best option. This wall I literally couldn't care less about. All of our stuff has flying essentially, so it doesn't matter. What are we looking to do next turn? Maybe just play this out, but we'll see. probably just gonna bounce this. Good thing about this, and this is just another reason why Sprite Dragon's so good, they bounce this, we just get to replay it, and it just doesn't matter. Like, who cares? Let's do that. Let's do this. We can also just shock here. Let's just shock this. Put the two here. It doesn't actually matter how we do that. It's 2 damage to the face either way. But gives us a way to deal with it. And we're also just boosting up, worth noting, our Crackling Drake here. So when we do drop this down, it's going to be a heck of a play. The problem with this is that it does not have haste, so it doesn't get to just come in and swing in immediately. That is why we're not running the full four. It's a great card, don't get me wrong, especially in a deck like this, but it just, this obviously, you know, not quite as strong on the onset, but ideally is going to be able to swing in for a lot more. That sucks, but it's really not the end of the world. Let's go ahead and play out the Drake. I'm going to shock this in. Worst case scenario, we will opt. Best case scenario, if they sweep again, we'll unsummon it. We've got some protection at least, so I'm happy with that. A lot of cool ways to kind of toolbox some of this stuff. Make sure they can't hit it. Great thing about this. Now they do, I mean, that's a good tempo play, don't get me wrong, but we get to redo this, and let's pass. Yep. That slows us down a little bit, but, and that's what this deck is going to be trying to do the whole time, so they may just outpace us, which is, you know, fine. Why did I not have the chance to respond? That kind of felt weird. Let's play Augur. Our little 1/3 doing the most. Beacon Bolt. Okay. Just opt here. Not very exciting, unfortunately. Throw that on the bottom. Okay. Not too unhappy with that, honestly. Just to give us a scry. Get rid of that mountain. Alright. They're going to get... I assume they're Teferi back next turn, right? Or Kahira. Why is Kahira in this, is what I'm wondering. I have not seen this, like, Esper list with Kahira. That feels kind of weird. I mean, maybe I'm just missing something. It just didn't seem... It seems just kind of weird, that's all. Yep. We do have the shock in hand, so if they bounce like Augur, that's fine, we can kill it. We also have the Scorching Dragonfire, so either one. And probably Scorching Dragonfire just to exile it if they're going to go that route. Excuse me. I really hope they go that route, because that's just extra value for us, honestly. And it mitigates this as a threat. I mean, they get Kahira, but we can kill that too. This is a bigger deal to me than Kahira, by a long way. Smokestack deck, huh? Well, in that case... Okay. They still bounced, so we're gonna have to sacrifice this, and that's fine. Let's Dragonfire that. Just to exile it. They may have a counter here, which would suck. But if this lands, it's exiled. That means we just don't have to worry about it anymore. And now on upkeep, they will have to... I guess they stack the triggers, but what can they get? Kahira, and then they have to sacrifice something? Oh, Omen. Sure. That makes sense. Yeah. I'm leaving up Shock so I can just... Scorching Dragonfire or Shock, really. Yep. That's fine. I'm gonna kill it. I'm gonna really kill it. They will, you know, get the value off of this, which is gonna suck, but like, it's not the worst thing in the world. Yep. Get a copy. That sucks. They're gonna get double value. Unfortunately, this is definitely a deck that's gonna outpower us long term. Yep. Discard a card. So they're gonna get tokens out of this. We'll discard Beacon Bolt. As much as I don't want to, I think we'll discard the Dragonfire. Just because we efficiently can deal with both of these tokens, so it really doesn't matter that much. We'll just deal with these and pass. Beacon Bolt is going to be dealing a butt ton of damage to something. Has to be a creature, but we're gonna overkill a 2/2. Like massively overkill. I will say, against this Doom Foretold deck, I definitely think we lose. Like, I don't think there's a way that we're gonna be able to win, but we've held our own longer than I kind of expected us to. We've managed to find ways, like the Scorching Dragonfires being able to exile Teferi, fantastic. Being able to exile the Kahira, also quite good. So now, like, any Elspeth Conqueror's Death that they play currently to deal with something we may draw, hopefully, is not really all that helpful. This is a problem. And this is the finisher, really, for this deck, so that makes sense. Only good news, they don't have haste. But, yeah. I played a deck like this. It was a teamer. I think it was teamer. It was a Miramance deck, though. So, no, it wouldn't have been teamer. I don't remember what it was, but it was really, really sweet. Let's discard this, draw a card. All right. They got us. All right, so, like I said, this deck is a very, very value-heavy deck, so well done on the opponent's side. They were able to deal with our threats, and that's all you got to do with that deck, so well done. Regardless, though, I like this deck. I was pleasantly surprised. I'll be honest, going into this one, I kind of thought, you know, Izzet Aggro is always kind of a first-try kind of deck. It's like anytime a new standard environment comes, if there's a good, like, Izzet Aggro deck, or card, excuse me, like the Sprite Dragon, they always get a test because it's like, okay, this is a really quick way to win. It's a very efficient way to win. And you get a lot of the like draw cards. You get a lot of the burn stuff. You get a lot of the toolbox stuff to deal with early aggro decks and a lot of the creature focus kind of stuff. Now with like Scorching Dragonfire, obviously, we also have ways to deal with Planeswalkers, which feels great. However, it has no tech at all against like enchantment decks like we just saw, like the Doom Foretold stuff. Not much we can do about it. We're looking to one for one. They're looking to get like five cards out of the graveyard and make them all four, or six cards, excuse me, make them all 4/4s and then be able to swing in. Unfortunately, that's just overpowering for an Izzet Aggro deck. That's not what it's looking to defend against. Ideally, it's looking to win before that. Unfortunately, we didn't. So overall, though, we won, I believe, a total of 4 games and lost 2, which is not bad considering, you know, this is kind of an experimental list. This is just kind of a test one. I like this. I would probably try and just kind of play a few more games and see how it goes. Don't think it's as quick by any means as like Rakdos Aggro, or excuse me, Mono Red. I do think it's actually potentially quicker than some of the Lurrus decks. Not all of them. Some of them are just crazy, crazy fast, and you can't do much about it. But it does a good job of like exiling stuff and doing that. So I think it has some legs against it. Unfortunately, we didn't get to see a match up there. But regardless, I had a good time playing this deck. Hopefully, you guys had a good time watching it. If you've got a deck list for us, share it down below. We'd love to try it out. We know Adam, our friend that suggested our Azorius Flyers deck, has given us like a ton of deck lists to try out. Adam, I promise we're getting to him. Don't feel bad. I know we haven't forgotten about you. But he sent us like 20 deck lists, like some crazy number, which is great. It's fun to be able to try those. And so we do have a few of them in the works that we're going to be jumping out at very, very soon. So thank you to him. Thank you in advance to anybody else that would like to submit. Please make sure you enter our Ikoria giveaway. Hopefully you can win a free Ikoria bundle. May 16th is going to be the day we choose our winner. So take a peek at that. Make sure you enter before then. So regardless, thanks a lot, guys. Really do appreciate all of the support, all the watch time. It's been fantastic. Really do appreciate it. So thank you, and I will see you very soon in the next gameplay video.